complessiva il premio Nobel della letteratura Mario Vargas Llosa.
I had no imagined, you know, before that socialism could represent a system so brutally repressive.
For five decades, Mario Vargas Llosa has captivated the world with his novels, leading to his recognition with the 2010 Nobel Prize in Literature. Like many Latin American writers, he was once a socialist. But if you assume Vargas Llosa conforms to the stereotype of a left-wing artist, you'll find yourself mistaken.
Which of these is your favorite caricature?
Oh, well, no, none. None. When Alan Garcia tried to nationalize the banks, we protest, you know. I wrote a manifest and we published with 100 signatures. And
this is the As a writer, Vargas Llosa has made a career out of defending his principles and questioning the assumptions of others. He's become an outspoken advocate of free markets and limited government, joining Atlas as its Templeton Leadership Fellow, and emerging as one of the world's most important freedom champions.
In my youth, I was a Marxist. I was a socialist. I had the idea that the only way in which we could fight all the injustices, the enormous inequalities, the exploitation of the poor by the very small minority of rich was socialism. I went five times to Cuba in the 60s. And then I started to discover that that reality was not as the image that I had, that I wanted to have of the Cuban Revolution. It was a fantastic euphemism, you know? And actually there were concentration camps in which were put together, you know, dissidents of common criminals, gays, and also people who were conspiring against the revolution. I remember that I wrote a letter to Fidel saying, I cannot understand, you know. This is totally against what you have said, what we thought that the Cuban Revolution was. And as other writers make a kind of protest about this, Fidel invited us to have a discussion with him. He was very impressive, but he was not convincing at all, you know. Utopia, which has produced the most extraordinary masterworks in art, in literature, philosophy, in social terms, has always been the most dangerous incentive of goal, because each time in history that a society has tried to materialize a kind of utopic vision of a perfect world has produced the most brutal, you know, and criminal kinds of regimes.
After his experiences in Cuba and a trip to the Soviet Union in 1967, Vargas Llosa began to use his writing to speak out against totalitarian regimes.
Private enterprise and the entrepreneur represent exploitation, discrimination, privilege. This is a prejudice that is deeply, deeply rooted in countries in which people have been suffering for centuries of the corruption and inefficacy of the state intervention in the economy.
Mario Vargas Llosa has reached beyond his writing to spread the ideas of liberty. Starting his own think tank in Spain, he has publicly challenged socialist leaders such as Venezuela's Hugo Chavez.
I am very grateful to institutions like Atlas, which are conscious of the importance of ideas if we want to reform society, if we want to destroy this very negative tradition of authoritarianism. keep this spirit alive, keep fighting on, because the victory is attainable, is there. It depends of us. We are the only responsibles of what will happen in the world, you know.